This is an I-beam. It is one of the most common building structures in many of the large buildings around our world. It has revolutionized our ability to build the skyscrapers you see in our amazing skylines. I-beams are extremely strong due to their very unique shape. But what makes this shape so strong? Let's look into what makes a beam so strong. One way we can analyze the strength of a beam is by measuring how much it deflects or bends due to an applied load. Let's rest our beam here on some supports at either end and apply uniformly distributed load across it. We can measure the displacement in the middle of the beam with this equation here. Q is our uniformly distributed load, L is the supported length of the beam, and E is our Young's modulus of elasticity. Simply, this is a property of the material which defines how stiff it is. It's measured by the stress or internal forces within that material and the plastic deformation that occurs. So a higher modulus of elasticity means the object is going to be stronger and less prone to bend. I is our second moment of inertia. This isn't the more commonly known first moment of inertia, which is an object's resistance to rotation. Rather, it's a property of an object's cross-section that is used to calculate the resistance to bending. We can calculate the second moment of inertia of an object by looking at its cross-section. Here, we can divide the area up into a bunch of little areas. Let's call one dA. Then we multiply that by y squared, which is the distance from the neutral axis, or the axis it bends about. And if we sum up all of these products, we will get the second moment of inertia. Since y is squared, if we distribute area further from the neutral axis, we can have a higher moment of inertia. Now, if we look back on our equation, if we have two beams that are the same length, the same material, and have the same force applied on them, the only variable left is our second moment of inertia. And since it's on the bottom of the equation, if we increase our second moment of inertia, then the beam deflection will decrease, therefore making the beam stronger. This makes sense because when a beam bends, the top goes into maximum compression, the bottom goes into maximum tension, and the middle feels no internal forces. So if we distribute material further from that neutral axis, i.e. having a higher second moment of inertia, then we will have a stronger beam. This is why the I-beam is such an efficient shape. The middle portion can be reduced to a size just small enough to combat shear stress, and the rest of the material can be placed at the top and bottom, where most of the compressive and tensile stresses are located. The I-beam isn't just some random shape, rather an engineering marvel that has changed history forever.